I'm James Tucker, and I'm the executive producer of Batman Hush.
So James, the question I have to ask you is, an 11-series comic book story, how did you cram that into a movie?
Very tightly. No, it wasn't easy to cram all that stuff in, as you say. You know, with any adaptation, you have to pick and choose. And so the thing Ernie Altbacker, the writer, and I decided on was that the through line should be the romance of Batman and Catwoman. Like, that's the thread that connects everything. Of course, there's the mystery of who Hush is and all the messing around he's doing with Batman's life and how dangerous he is and how he's slowly ratcheting up the tension and getting close to Batman in ways that Batman has never had to deal with. He's had other villains who knew his secret identity, but like Ra's al Ghul doesn't hate him. He respects him, and so he doesn't think there's anything to be gained by exposing his secret identity. Whereas Hush hates Batman, and he knows Batman on an intimate, personal level in a way that no other villain would. And so that gives Batman an extra challenge, as well as trying to juggle his relationship with Catwoman, who's trying to help him. But she's still also trying to convert him a little bit. She still wants him on her side of the fence. And so he's getting it from all sides. And his relationship with Catwoman is almost making him more vulnerable to what Hush is doing. So it's all tied together. We tried to keep, you know, like comics are monthly. And so the reader can create the connective tissue between issues. When you have to boil it down to a movie, that's more passive experience, meaning you have to give the viewer more information. They're not going to fill it all in, so it's a different experience is what I'm saying.
Did you ever decide sitting down maybe thinking this could be a series on DC Direct?
Oh.
Did it ever come up?
I mean, the thing is, you know, comics and episodic television have a lot more in common than comics and movies. That's why, you know, Marvel does their movie universe the way they do it, because they've recreated what it's like to read a comic. You know, if one movie kind of sucks, the next movie's coming along, you're still going to go. And so we're with these.
Sorry, yeah, that's good though.
That's how you read a comic, right?
You're not wrong.
Hulk book isn't going to make you dump the comic, right? So, and I'm saying we're comparing ourselves to them, but we're doing a continuity. And we're trying to do it like comics in that, you know, especially comics now where a thread from one book connects to another book to another. So the stuff that's in Hush is we're using characters we built up. The Superman that appears in this story and the Lois that appears in this story are the same ones you just saw in Death of Superman. So their relationship to Clark, Bruce is already known. You know, you don't have to reintroduce, you don't have to set up new stuff. And so that's why I think Hush needed to be part of a continuity. But to answer your question, sure, if I had a Batman television series, then you could adapt Hush almost page by page. And although I'd still want to change some things.
But that was the question, was like, would that ever come up in the pre-production phase? Like, we could do this as a series.
Yeah, but I mean, my gig right now is making movies. If I get a gig making series again,
You're not making movies anymore. Right.
If I'm not, then that question is applicable. But in a meeting where you say, well, actually, this would be better as a series, people go, but we want a movie.
Okay.
And so you got to do, right? Or you're, you know. So.
So my last question is.
Yes, it came up.
I will.
That's
your question.
Good. Yes, okay.
Yes, it did.
So my final question is, I'm a big Robin fan.
Okay.
Specifically, Tim Drake. And now I'm curious because I've seen Bad Blood, Red Hood, all those other ones. He tends to take a back seat and you focus on Nightwing. Is that because they tend to play the same role in the comic story arc? So you're just like, well, we're just going to do Nightwing instead because he's older or what?
I'll put it this way. He doesn't exist in our continuity yet.
Oh, I like that.
I had plans for Tim Drake. That's all I'm saying. So
just keep an eye. You keep your ear to the ground.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't hate Tim.